Good morning, student. I Purnima welcome you to the class, and I was teaching you models. So first of all, children, what is a model? So verb that express the mood or attitude of the speaker is a model. The verb that express the mood or attitude of the people is a of a speaker is called a model. Children, I told you the moods and attitude expressed in the sentence given below are advice, necessity, seeking permission and giving permission both, giving permission in a friendly and informal manner, giving permission in a formal manner, making a polite request. So children, this shows the mood and attitude are expressed in the sentence in this way only, which I've discussed with you with my previous in my previous video. Now children, I told you the most commonly used models are can, could, may, might, shall, should, dare, ought to, need, okay, must, will, would. So these are some of the models, important model which I think you should know. Can, could, may, might, shall, should, okay, dare, ought to, must, will, and would. So these are some of the important model. Now children, what does a model suggest? Let me see, why models are used. The thing is that models are used because, children, it suggests to give permission first, it suggests to tell us about ability, then possibility, suggestion, advice, duty, promise, intention, request, necessity, compulsion, provision, wish. Okay, so these are some of the models, and children, these models, they used to tell us this thing only: permission, ability, possibility, suggestion, advice, duty, promise, intention, request, necessity, compulsion, provision, wish. Okay, so before we try to understand, children, I also told you that some of the important characteristic of models. So what is the first characteristic? So children, models are always followed by the main verbs. Whenever we use models, there is always a main verb, like we will go to the market. We will go to the market. So this is the model. This is the main verb. Okay, so children, models are always followed by the main verb. Then second point, modal do not change its form with the person and number of the subject. Whatever may be the subject, they remain the same. So this is one another characteristic of modal is there. They do not change form with the person and number of the subject. Whatever may be the subject, they remain the same. Then the main verb used after modal must be in the root form. Present participle, past and past participle forms of a verb are never used with models. Okay, so normally models are followed by a main verb. In question tags, however, they can be used alone. Models always have the same form. The main verb used after model is always in the root form. Okay, now children, I will be explaining you those models. ओके नाउ वी विल बी डूइंग द कंपैरेटिव स्टडी अबाउट द मॉडल. लाइक चिल्ड्रन आई टोल्ड यू सम ऑफ द मॉडल्स आर यूज फॉर गिविंग परमिशन, सम ऑफ द मॉडल्स आर यूज फॉर एबिलिटी. सो आई विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद द एबिलिटी. ओके सो विच आर द मॉडल्स यूज फॉर एबिलिटी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल लेट यू नो दिस थिंग. विच आर द मॉडल्स आर यूज फॉर एबिलिटी. सो फॉर एबिलिटी children can put and be able to. So first is ability. What are the model use? Can, could, and then be able to. Okay, this is the first. So the idea of ability, children, first of all, the first model which express the idea of ability is can. ओके इस कैन इन दिस सेंस कैन मीन्स बी एबल टू और बी कैपेबल ऑफ नो हाउ टू. एबिलिटी इन द पास्ट इज एक्सप्रेस बाई कुड कैन एंड कुड ऑल्सो सजेस्ट अपॉर्चुनिटी. द आइडिया ऑफ एबिलिटी इज एक्सप्रेस बाई कैन इन दिस सेंस कैन मीन्स बी एबल टू और बी कैपेबल ऑफ नो हाउ टू. एबिलिटी इन द पास्ट इज एक्सप्रेस बाई कुड can and could also suggest opportunity. So once again children I would like to tell you, children can express the ability. I can do this, I can swim for 5 hours, I can drive cars for the whole night. So this idea of ability is expressed by the model can. Can means be able to or be capable of or know how to. Ability in the past is expressed by could. Can and could also suggest opportunity. Okay. Kiran can keep wickets. Kiran is able to keep wickets. Kiran knows how to keep wickets, but this sentence may also mean Kiran has the opportunity to keep wickets. But there is a slight difference between. Kiran could keep wickets. Kiran was able to keep wickets. Kiran could keep wickets and Kiran was able to keep wickets. Sentence 1 means Kiran knew how to keep wickets, but the sentence does not state clearly whether he kept wickets or not. In sentence 2 suggests that Kiran actually kept wickets. Kiran was able to keep wickets. He actually kept the wickets. The important thing is that don't write Kiran can could be able to keep wickets. This is wrong. So whereas can is used for the present and could for the past, be able to can be used in any tense. So we were able to swim across the river. He is able to sell most of the vegetable by evening. Present, I'm sure I will be able to attend your birthday celebration. Future. Okay. Now children, the next is possibility. Okay, the next important mood which is expressed by model is possibility. Possibility. Okay, so may, might, and could. Okay, this suggests possibility. May, might, and could. May, might, and could suggest possibility. Okay. So here, children, may suggest a good possibility, might suggest a weak possibility, and could also express a very weak possibility in the future. So may suggest a good possibility. Don't worry, your purse may be in your bag. Might suggest a weak possibility and could a still weaker possibility. Could also express a very weak possibility in the future. I'm glad she could come yesterday. Ability the past. She could come tomorrow. A very weak possibility in the future. Now, so I was telling you children, possibility, the three main models for possibility is may, might and could. As you can see, it's written on the board. Now let me tell you about may, might and could. May suggest a good possibility. Don't worry, your purse may be in your bag. Might suggest a weak possibility and could a still weaker possibility. Could also expresses a very weak possibility in the future. Look at the use of could in this sentence. I'm glad she could come yesterday. This is ability in the past. She could come tomorrow, a very weak possibility in the future. Okay. Rewrite the, now children. So now I will be coming to the next children part, and that is suggestion. Now which models I'm going to take? It is suggestion. Should. So should is used to here express suggestion or advice. So children, should is the only main strong models to suggestion. Okay, so should we start packing the luggage? This is suggestion. You should include another fast bowler in the team. This is suggestion. You should try to reduce your weight. So this is advice. Okay, ought to is little stronger than should. Now I will be telling you a new model, which is ought to. It is a little stronger than should. It suggests that something is the right thing to do. It also conveys a sense of duty. You ought to take care of your old parents, moral duty. You ought to take care of your old parents. This is a moral duty. You aren't keeping fit. You ought to go for a morning walk every day. You ought to go for a morning walk every day. Now, children, promise and will and share. So, promise is will and share. Okay, so will and shall are used to suggest promise. Normally we use shall with only first person. Children, generally children, we know that I and we, they are the first person. I singular and we plural, and it is known that I and we is generally used to suggest promise. Normally we use shall with only first person subject and will with all persons. But if a promise is to be suggested, we use will with first person subjects and shall with other persons. Now children, if the promise is to be suggested, we use will with first person subjects and shall with other person. We will attend your brother's marriage. We will attend your brother's marriage. It is our promise. You shall get a new bed on your birthday. It is my promise. Don't worry, I will write. I promise. They shall get all concession given to others. I promise that they will. So we will attend your brother's marriage. It is our promise. You shall get a new bat on your birthday. It is my promise. Don't worry, I will write. I promise. Then they shall get all concession given to others. I promise that they will. So children, this is promise. Okay. So this is promise, and the main models which is used for promise is will and shall. So will and shall are used to suggest promise. We use shall with only first person, and it is assumed. It is assumed that will and shall is usually used to suggest promise and will with all other person, and shall with only first person. But if a promise is to be suggested, we use will with first person subject and shall with other person. We will attend your brother's marriage. We will attend your brother's marriage. It is our promise. You shall get a new bat on your birthday. It is my promise. Don't worry. I will write. I promise. They shall get all concession given to other. I promise that they will. Now children, intention. Okay. So what is here children, intention is also related with will and shall. Okay. Intention is also related with will and shall. So will and selection in their normal uses suggest intention or willingness. I shall ring you up in the evening. I shall ring you up in the evening. Intention. He will help you in business. He will help you in business. Intention or willingness. We shall write to all the newspaper. Intention. They will gladly cooperate. Willingness. They will gladly cooperate. Willingness. Request. So would, won't, can, could. Okay. Request. Would, won't, can, could. Would you buy me some woolens, please? Okay. Now it's a polite request. Would you buy me some woolen, please? Could you switch on the fan? It's a polite request, but it is uncertain. Can I have some tea? Informal. Won't you have something to eat? Have something to eat. There is not much difference in these forms, and we could use any of them. Well, now. Get me a cup of tea. Now children, if this sentence is there, how you will help me? Help it to write with request. So you can write it, could you get me a cup of tea, or would you get me a cup of tea? Now I will come with the prohibition. Must not, ought not to. Must not, ought not to. Okay. So which must not and ought not. Ought not to. Okay, must not and ought not to. So, children, cart must not be parked in front of the gate. It is prohibited to park cart in front of the gate. So, children, with prohibition, which things we do use? We use must not. Then you ought not to make fun of an old man. As a duty, you should not make fun of an old man. It is your moral duty that you should not make fun of the old man. Okay. Now, wish. Wish is generally we use children. May is generally here used here to express a wish. Okay, so wish is that model which is generally used with the help of which model? May is normally used to express a wish. For example, may you live long. May God bless you with a son. May God bless you with a son. Okay. Then dare. I daren't climb that tall tree. The child dare not complained. Dare you challenge him to fight? No, I daren't. Okay. So in the above sentences, dare has been used as a model and it means not to be afraid to do something. We use dare mostly in negative sentence and in question. So children, just remember, mostly dare is used in negative sentence. Okay, we use generally in negative sentence and in question. Dare can also be used as a normal verb. Then negative and questions are formed with do and did. I don't dare to climb that tall tree. The child did not dare to complain. Do you dare to challenge him to a fight? No, I don't. These sentences can also be written without the use of the to verb. I don't dare climb that tall tree. The child did not dare complain. Do you dare challenge him to a fight? No, I don't. So these sentences can also be written without the use of the verb to. I don't dare climb that tall tree. The child did not dare complain. Do you dare challenge him to a fight? No, I don't. Now, so children, these were some of the important were there. Then of course permission, may, can and could. These are the important things, very important children, models to take permission. Okay, may, can, could. So once again I write, permission. May, can, could. Okay. Now children, can is used for informal permission. May is used for formal permission and could is more polite than may. Could is more polite than may. May, can and could are used to suggest permission. Can is informal, may is polite, could is more polite than may. The proper model to be used depends upon the person involved and the situation. May, can and could are used to suggest permission. Can is informal, may is polite, could is more polite than may. The proper model to be used depends upon the person involved and the situation. Two friends talking. Can I use your book, Anjum? Anjum said, yes, you can. So this is informal. Since Shikha and Anjum are friends, so they don't have to be very much formal. So they have used can. A student talking to her teacher, Garima, may I go to the library, madam? Teacher, yes, you may. What books do you want? So this, you can see, this is a what to tell, formal. Then two subordinate are there. Satish Kumar, sir, could you grant me 2 days leave? Officer, you may take leave if there is nothing urgent in the offices. So children, here subordinate is being very polite while the officer is giving a formal permission. Can I use your telephone? Can I use your telephone? This is formal or informal? This is informal. Because children, a very close person can ask, may I use your telephone? This is formal. Could I use your telephone? Very polite. Yes, you may. Yes, you may. Permission granted formally. No, you may not. Permission is denied. Okay. So this is the thing, children. Now, ability, I told you. Now, one. Must. Children, must suggest the desire of the speaker. Have to suggest an external compulsion. Had to suggest an external compulsion. So what does must suggest? Desire. Okay. You must pay the dues on time. In the army, you have to clean your shoes yourself. So sentence must meet the speaker want the dues to be paid on time. In sentence 2 means that the army rules requires everybody to clean his shoes himself. Now, need not suggest that there is no necessity or compulsion. Need not means there is no necessity or compulsion. He did not go to the doctor. You did not get up so early. You did not work so hard for your examination because your examination is still 4 months away. Okay, so these are some of the things. Then necessity, compulsion, must. I am getting late, I must take a taxi. This is necessity. I am getting late, I must take a taxi. So must is used when the compulsion is there. You must pay the dues on time. Again, this is necessity and compulsion. In the army, you have to clean your shoes. This is a compulsion. Since he was not at home, I had to wait for him. Necessity. I have got to finish this work by evening. Necessity and compulsion. I will have to go and get some medicine. Necessity and compulsion. Okay. So, children, these are some of the thing which we have discussed. Prohibition, must not. Car must not be parked in front of the gate. It is prohibited to park car in front of the gate. And children, it is your duty not to do that thing. So what the thing you will use here? Ought to. You ought not to make fun of an old man. As a duty, you should not make fun of the old man. So, as a duty, you should not make fun of the old man. Okay. Now, so children, what is their request? Would you buy me some woolen, please? This is a polite request. When we do some polite request, then children, it is would. And when it is promise, okay, then with we also, if it is promise, then we can use with we also. If it is a promise, then we can use we with will be used with we also. Intention. Will and shall in their normal uses suggest intention or willingness. He will help you in business. He will help you in business. Okay. So this is the children. Then in suggestion should. is to express both suggestion or advice. We should include another fast bowler in the team. This is a suggestion. And advice, children, what is advice? You should try to reduce your weight. So this is advice also. Okay, so these were some of the important model, and with this I conclude my lesson today. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.